Are you looking for a simple yet powerful to-do list application? Today we will be diving into Any.Do, which is an application I actually reviewed back in 2017 when I looked very fresh-faced and much more less haggard than I do now. Today we're going to look at Any.Do. It is an application that has been around on the market for some time, and it was primarily pushed as very much a mobile application that combines tasks and calendar. Well, they've really evolved, and this latest version incorporates managing your own time using a daily planner type methodology, combining it with a work-based application and boards. So we're gonna have a look, give you a better idea of whether this is right for you. So if you're new to the channel, I'm Francesco. I'm excited to dive into today's video, but if you are in the hunt for productivity tools, I would love to have you over on Toolfinder, because we've got a growing resource there. Lists, categories, just everything you need about productivity apps. It's the go-to place, the car dealership for productivity apps. So I'd love to have you over there. And if you're in hunt beyond Any.Do for more applications, find us over there. So here we are at Any.Do itself. This is a nice refresh. The application looks a lot sleeker, a lot nicer. And here we are with the Mac version. Now they have a web version and a few different versions of it that you can find on the website. But primarily this application wants you to help you to use as a daily plan. So up here you can see a calendar that I've connected it to. You can connect an Outlook and a Google Calendar, and I've connected it and I can see my next meeting. If I click into it, I can see things like the Microsoft Teams link and some meeting details, stuff you'd expect to see in Google Calendar. But down here I've got this area, which is basically my task list for the day. And if I click into a task, I can see stuff like remind me, and what list it is actually part of. Now you can see over here, you can create new lists, and this is my personal list. I'll come back to that because that's quite a nice view. But this is where you do most of your actions for the day. This is a today area, it's called My Day, and it sort of takes inspiration from Microsoft To-Do here, because on the right-hand side, there's this little icon that has a light bulb. And what it does is it allows you to see your tasks that are part of other projects. These are all suggestions, and basically it pulls together the suggestions across all the different lists you have and allows you to bring them into your day. So here's a demo one. You can simply just bring them in, and that's quite a nice view. But there's also a little bit of a hidden view here. There's events, and events are basically a way for you to see anything on your Google Calendar or Outlook Calendar. And it's great because it's great for being able to see what's ahead of time. But you can also, you can't drag them on, which would be a nice feature if Any.Do are watching. But that's something that allows you to see your events alongside your tasks. For now, you can't drag them on, which is a shame. So if I tuck this away, I can also do things like pin a certain item, which is perfect for if you have something really important on your list. You can also add notes to them, add tags, and tick them off, as well as archive them. But you can add attachments, and even there's an AI function in the premium which allows you to suggest subtasks. But here I can start just pumping away at some subtasks that are part of this, which can be quite helpful. So moving on, the list view is really nice because you get a way to see your list, which you can add more tasks to, and a way to really see the details of the tasks. So this is great for just breaking them down. You can do some regular sorting. You convert it to a board as well, which is what I'll show you in a minute. And you can also use AI to basically produce a set of recommendations. So here they've obviously picked personal ones. I don't know how useful that feature is, because it depends on when you're starting a project from fresh. It could be the grocery list. It might save you a bit of time, but you can start adding some items there. So in terms of the board view, I think this is quite nice because the board view is sort of incorporated in a few different ways. There's this like upcoming view, which allows you to drag tasks between stuff, sort of like a Kanban board for planning ahead, which is quite nice. And you can scrabble between your work tasks and your own tasks, which is very nice. You can see all of your tasks, which span across all the different days, which is more of like a linear version of that. And finally, you can go ahead and create a view. Now, creating a view can be dependent on people, due dates, and boards. So if I go to boards and I bring in a board for company overview, which is a part of the experience I've got for there. So you can start to see that this can be quite helpful for restructuring content that you already have. And if you've got people working with you, you can break it down per person as well. So if I go to this view here, which is a workspace account, I'll go through the pricing for those different stuff a bit later on, but I can see a board view, I can share it with other people, and I can view it as a Kanban, a table, which is great once you've added more metadata to it. A little bit, reminds me a little bit of like TaskAid, and finally a calendar view. So that's the abilities you do get in the in the workspace areas. So it's, again, much more lighter. You can see weekend view can make some multiple edits, but largely it allows you to plan ahead and add tasks as well. And you can add it to certain sections that you're in. So if I go back to the, you can do some filtering there too. If I go back to this view, then I can still do stuff like open up items and start taking notes. And down the bottom here, I can add checklists and stuff like that. So you can also see any notifications up here, but that's really all in terms of functionality. It's actually quite a thinned out application, but from when I last reviewed it, it's definitely grown in what it can do. And the team level functionality is, whilst it's light, it's something that they didn't have before. So let's take a look at pricing. I'm on the free plan right now. I'm not on a workspace account, but actually that's not technically a workspace account because I'm on a trial. But if I were to go to, let's find the paid, let's work out how to get the paid pricing up. If I go to, here we go. So I'm technically on the paid version of this because I'm on the 14-day free trial. But if you were to go with billed annually, it's $60 per person, or if billed monthly, $7.99, which is on the lower end of the spectrum for team pricing. So this is probably much more suitable for a team of like 5 to 10 maximum, really, because it's quite light in its nature. But that's a fairly reasonable price for that. And I believe the pricing for the personal user is $2.99 a month if billed annually, which prices itself more in the realm of the TickTick as a competitor. But naturally that's billed annually. I think the monthly of that is $5.99 if you're wanting to test out a few of the features first. So that is Any.Do, and the application itself, it looks really nice. It has a few elements that I don't particularly like it. There's over animation here. Some of the functionality feels a little bit strange, like my lists and personal. It's sort of, I don't know, it feels a bit too cluttered in some areas, but largely the application has some really interesting potential, especially in the daily planner market, which is where a lot of the space in to-do list applications is heading. We've actually got a list of daily planner applications if you're interested on Toolfinder, but largely this application seems a very interesting one and has evolved a lot since I last checked it out. So folks, if you're interested in any of these apps or Any.Do, whatever it is, you can find them in the link in the description. But of course, if you're interested in finding a productivity tool, whether it's a to-do app or many more of them, you can jump over to Toolfinder. But thank you very much. If you are new here, do subscribe. If you are eager to dive into tools, go over to Toolfinder. But folks, I will see you very soon anyway. And I hope you have one of the best days ever. Cheerio.